Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and it's spring cleaning in the barn. Some of you noticed the last update I did on the animals, I didn't mention the rabbits, and that's because I wanted to do a separate video on the rabbits. So, yeah, I am getting senile, but not quite that senile yet. Anyway, some of you have asked how my husband hung up our rabbit cages. So, while I'm cleaning, while I'm cleaning, there's all the rabbit cages. I thought that would be a good time to explain that because I can get to everything. So if you're thinking about putting in a rabbitry and you have a building, an existing building with stud walls, you could probably duplicate this. What he did was he put these little hooks up here to hang the back of the cages, and then he suspended chains to catch the front. Now this will be for the top cages, and this one catches the bottom cages. And very easy. And then the trays, the bottom trays sit on these boards that he's got coming out. And then the top trays for the top cages sit right on top of the bottom cages. And I'll put one in and you can maybe see better what I'm talking about. Okay, I've got the cages up, just hooked on the back hook without any support in the front. And they're pretty sturdy, empty. And probably with a lighter weight breed of rabbit, like a Netherland dwarf or something like that, you'd be fine. You wouldn't have to do these chains. But when you get a fat New Zealand in there with a litter, it puts a little bit of strain on those back hooks. So just to be on the safe side, we use the little hooks up front. And you just pick them up. You can see the chain is nothing. Oops. Well, you can't see unless I put it in focus. The chain is nothing too substantial. But it just gives it a little bit more security. Oh, it figures it. Oh, there we go. Now you have to get these centered pretty well because you don't want these chains. You want them hanging pretty straight, so you have to get this centered just right. And I'll put the bottom one in. Okay, now they're all back together, and this works out really nicely. These are newer pans. I had the little plastic ones in here before, and now they've come out with these metal, deeper pans, much nicer. They don't warp when you're trying to take them out, because most rabbits will go in one corner of their cage. So when you try to slide these out, usually it's the back of the cage. That corner always wants to tip on you, and the plastic ones, they'd actually break. So these metal ones are a big improvement. These are actually the largest commercially made rabbit cages you can buy that I've ever seen. They're 36 by 30 inches. My philosophy is the biggest cage you can find, afford, fit in your circumstances, the better. Especially with these larger breeds like New Zealands and Californians. They have rather large litters, and the more room you can give them, it's just nicer. Okay, let's talk about some of the accessories that you will need for your rabbitry. And of course, one of the most important things is your water bottle. There's different ways to water. You can water with just a simple little pan. Keep in mind, however, rabbits are chewers, and if you use plastic, you might wind up with this situation. I have one that likes to chew. So this is usually your best bet. These just hang on the outside of your cages. You can fill them with frozen water in the summer, and the rabbit learns to help themselves, and you can monitor, you know, how much water each rabbit is drinking real easily. And of course you can hook a smaller bottle than that one. Also, a nice thing to do in the heat of the summer is to put frozen empty pop bottles like this one, oh, small ones, in your freezer, and once they're frozen, lay them in the cage and the rabbits will kind of get up next to them, and it helps to cool them off. They really appreciate that. In the winter, I tried these electric rabbit waterers. They have like a little nipple like they use for pig waterers. They have a miniature one for the rabbits. I like them when they work. I had two that sprung leaks, two that went through the winter, no problem. It got really cold a few nights, and below zero, well below zero, and these things kept the water unfrozen. The other nice thing I like about them is they don't keep it so warm that algae grows. The only time I had algae growing in these was when the weather warmed up. All winter long, no problem. So when they work, they're great, and both of them sprung leaks. I think it's in the seal down here by my thumb, so I might be able to repair them. I got to look at them a little better. I'm going to try them again, especially if I can get the other two repaired. To feed, you can use, again, these little metal dishes. They clamp on the inside, so you can, let me just show you here. You can just hook them over and then squeeze it down. I found it's really hard to keep the rabbits from not taking them off and dumping. I have naughty, naughty bunnies apparently. Even so, if I get the pliers out and I really clamp them down, then they're okay. But a better solution, these two are over here making all kinds of noise. They're so jealous. A better solution would be, let me go outside here, would be these kinds of feeders. And they clamp right on to the outside. There's a little screw, a little wing nut and screw. And there's no way that rabbit can move that or dump it. These are, to me, the best solution. However, they're made out of plastic. Now, the lip is a little thicker, so you may not have the same problem you do on those little skinny plastic feeders or bowls. But I haven't used these yet. But I'll let you know. But I really like the idea that you can clamp them down, because I have a couple rabbits that enjoy spilling their pellets. Other kind of feeders. This is the one I use. One of my females that is really bad about spilling. This is, you can hook it on the outside or the inside. Of course, it's getting hooked where I don't want it. If you're going to hook it on the outside of your rabbit cage, you need to cut a hole so that this part, this is so hard not to have an extra hand. Three. Okay. This part would go inside the cage. This part would hang outside the cage, and then you can just fill it. This is so frustrating. You can just fill it from the outside because the top flips up, which it's of course not doing because I'm shooting a video and it's, there we go. See, and so if you have that like so up in your rabbit cage, you can see how easy it would be to fill it from the outside. I just hook mine on the inside because I don't like cutting holes in the cages. So, and that's what these little hooks back here are for, okay? These, in case you're wondering, go to the electric heater water. But I'm going to use it for the other waters too. So you have that, and they come in metal and plastic. Again, you're probably going to get chewing if you use the plastic, depending on the rabbit. Oh, you guys make me so mad. I'm having a battle with my goats. They keep spilling their mineral, and so I keep adding more tie-downs to it. I'm determined to beat my goats at their own game. speaking of chewing, that's something I don't see mentioned on very many rabbit videos. And that's giving your rabbit, especially if they're in an all-metal cage, something to chew on, like pieces of wood. Nothing treated, of course, but just give them, sometimes I use bark, pieces of bark like this. Just give them something to chew on. Because if you don't, they're going to find something to chew on. And their incisors, their front incisors, grow continuously. If you don't give them something to chew on, they're going to have teeth problems. So untreated boards, these boards that you're going to put in their pen for them to stand on, they can chew on those. And I've got, you know, a piece of plywood here and an old barn wood here, and I use that. Again, you're going to use untreated wood. And that's something you're going to want to do is put a piece of wood of some type in your cage so that your rabbits are always standing on the metal, on the mesh down here. Very hard on their feet, and they'll get what they call hutch burn, and very painful for them. So just give them a place to give their feet a break. Doesn't have to be anything fancy. Okay, one last thing you're going to need if you're breeding rabbits, and that's a place. You don't want to know what mess I'm making. A place for them to have their babies. And they sell these. These are commercial made nesting boxes. They come with this little corrugated, I call it glorified, cardboard, but it works great. It's ventilated. And you put that in there, and only use these when your doe is about to have babies. I found if I put them in the cage or try to keep them in the cage year-round, they use them as toilets. And they're hard to keep clean. So just put them in when she's going to have her babies. Now you'll notice if you want to make your own, perfectly acceptable. However, you do want a lip on the front. It's nice and open. She's going to put straw and bedding and her own hair in here and make a nice nest. But you want a lip on the front so that when she jumps out, it catches any babies that are hanging on and they stay in the nest. Because if the babies fall out onto the floor of the cage, she's not like a cat. She's not going to pick them up and put them back in. They're going to stay there until you put them back in. And if it's cold at night, they're going to freeze to death. when they're newborn anyway. So make sure if you do make your own nesting boxes or use something for a nesting box, it has a lip to catch the babies. Once they're about 3 weeks old, they can jump in and out on their own and they're fine. So, but there's just some basics if you're thinking about putting some rabbits somewhere on your property. We really like keeping rabbits. We're going to continue and we're probably going to expand a little bit. Our next project after this garage sale this weekend and everything else we got going on is to make some outdoor hutches. And if that's your option, then I'll make a video about that and what we did. And we're going to use these cages and just basically put a frame around them and some legs. So, all right, that's all. Now you have a rabbit update. Oh, speaking of the rabbits, you're probably wondering, where are the rabbits? Well, let me show you. I have both my females in my indoor goat pen. When it's storms and blizzards, I like to put my goats in here. And they are getting along famously. They're sisters, and they've been separated to raise their babies in those cages that I just left. But they're doing just fine back in together. They started out together, and now they're back together. No fighting, no squabbling. In fact, you can't see them. I wish you could, but they're both in that little house together. Snuggled up. They're very communal with each other. Now, I had two sisters from a litter that I had to separate. They got to the point where they didn't want to live together, but these two aren't like that. I'm very intrigued with the whole idea of a rabbit commune, and these two would certainly lend themselves to that with their temperaments. I would love to let them raise their babies in here together. They're both bred, or they should be, but I don't trust my barn cats. I think my barn cats would think this was a lovely rabbit buffet if there were babies in there. So I'm going to have to put them back in the cages, and at least till their babies get big enough that the cats don't think that. I did put my male in with them, and for a couple days they all lived happily. He was very happy to be in with them. I tried breeding them by taking one of them to his cage, and she didn't take. So a friend said, put both your females together, put the male in, they'll get competitive. They'll both get bred. He used to run a large rabbitry. So I did that, and they should be due this weekend if everything worked out. So we'll find out. But they're just so cute. I've got to show them. I don't know if it's going to be too dark, but let me see if I can get in here. And this is Ginger and Paprika. I'm sorry, girls. I am disturbing you. I know. And you just are in here having just the nicest little time together, aren't you? Yeah. Hello. Are you out? Again, I love to give them this big area, but I have to take it away from them so they can have their babies. And my other dilemma is I have to start locking up the little goat, Ella, at night because she's stealing all the milk. There's no milk for me in the morning. For a while there, she was taking all her milk off one side, and I could milk her the other side out in the morning and get 2 quarts and be happy. And now she's getting bigger, and she's drinking more milk and taking all of it. So we'll lock her up at night, so that the Marty's milk is full in the morning. I'll take what I need, and then she can go in with her mother and she can get some. And I'll also start giving her a little calf manna at night to make up for that. She's old enough now, she should start getting more calories from hay and a little bit of grain or calf manna. So she'll be fine. But so that's why I've got to move. The other reason I got to move the girls, so I can have this pen at night. That's where the girls are, and I have a little hutch outside where the buck is. And my husband finally got around to processing our other rabbits, and they're in the freezer. Because, oh, I got a big freezer. Woohoo! And here's another little popular hutch that TFC sells. And this lifts up. It's very accessible. It has a door in the front, and then this opens up as well, this inner part. But to me, this is way too small. Maybe for a Netherland dwarf, a single rabbit. But for a larger breed rabbit for any length of time, and especially a litter, this is too small. Don't buy these hutches for that. he's talking to me. It's probably maybe 24 by 24, or no, probably 18 by 24. Very small. We bought it for our guinea pig in the summer, and we're hopefully going to sell her in a garage sale this weekend. But it works as a spare pen right now when I need a place to go with them, but I wouldn't raise a litter and I wouldn't keep a rabbit in it indefinitely, for sure. That's just me.